Hello students, my name is Gautam and I am your maths teacher. Today's video is for class 6, chapter number 8, algebraic expressions, part 3. Okay, we have already covered two parts of this chapter. Now we are going to start part 3, in which we will do exercise 8D. Okay, in exercise 8D, questions will be based on simplification, algebraic expressions will be given and we need to simplify them. Further and get the final answer. Okay, so let's start with exercise 8D. In exercise 8D, first I will take question number 3. The heading of the question is simplify, and question is in one bracket a square plus 2ab plus b square then minus a square plus 2ab plus b square. Here it will be minus 2ab. So this is the question and we need to simplify it and find the final answer. Okay, so let's proceed. First step, we will open this brackets. Whenever there is minus sign outside the bracket, we change the inside term, sign of the inside terms. So this will be written as it is, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now here we will open the bracket and we will change the sign of inside terms. This will become plus 2ab and plus b square will become minus b square. Okay. Now this plus a square minus a square will be cancelled. Similarly, plus b square minus b square will also be cancelled and we will be left with 2ab plus 2ab, which is 4ab. This is the final answer, 4ab. After question number 3, we will see question number 6. Question number 6 is minus 2 bracket x square minus y square plus xy in one bracket, then minus 3 x square plus y square minus xy in the other bracket. So let us solve it. First we will multiply this minus 2 inside. So we will get minus 2x square, minus 2y square and minus plus will give us, sorry, here minus 2 into minus y square will give us plus 2y square. Similarly, minus 2 into xy will give us minus 2xy. Now let us multiply minus 3 inside, minus 3x square, minus 3 into y square, minus 3y square, minus 3 into minus xy will give us plus 3xy. Now let us bring the like terms together, minus 2x square, minus 3x square, then plus 2y square, minus 3y square. Now xy terms, minus 2xy plus 3xy. Let us simplify it further. Minus 2x minus 3x square will give us minus 5x square. Plus 2y square minus 3y square will give us minus y square. Minus 2xy plus 3xy will give us plus xy. This will be our final answer. Okay. Now let's move to the next question. Next question that we will take from this exercise is question number 11. Question number 11. number 11 is 5a minus square bracket a square minus small bracket curly bracket this curly bracket 2a then small bracket 1 minus a plus 4a square small bracket close and minus 3a a square minus 5a minus 3 all brackets closed and at last minus 8a. So this is the question. Let us simplify it. Children, order of brackets, you all know how to solve the order of brackets. First order is bar, then a small, first bar bracket, then small bracket, then curly braces, and then square bracket or big bracket. So we'll follow this order only. First we will solve the small bracket. Okay. So let's proceed. 5a minus a square curly bracket. Now we will multiply 2a inside. 2a into 1 is 2a minus 2a square plus 8a cube. 2a into 4a square will give us 8a cube. Now let us multiply with this minus 3a. So minus 3a into a minus 3a cube. Then plus 15a square. Then plus 9a. Okay, we open the bracket. Small bracket is solved. Curly bracket will be there. Minus 8a. After this next step, 5a minus a square. Now we can solve the curly braces. How to solve? Bring the line terms together. Let us first bring the a cube terms together. 8a cube minus 3a cube. After this, let us bring the 3a square terms together. 2a square plus 15a square. Then a terms. Plus 2a plus 9a. All the terms we have taken. Now curly bracket then square bracket minus 8a. Okay. Now let us simplify. Inside curly bracket a square minus 8a cube minus 3a cube will give you 5a cube. Minus 2a square plus 15a square will give us plus 13a square plus 2a plus 9a will give us plus 11a minus 8a. Now we can open the curly bracket and sign of inside term will change. Why? Because there is minus sign outside the curly bracket. So 5a minus a square minus 5a cube minus 13a square minus 11a. Curly bracket has been removed. Okay. Now we can also remove the square bracket and we will change the sign of inside terms. First, if you want, we can solve this square bracket. 5a minus a square minus 13a square will give us minus 12a square minus 5a cube minus 11a and this minus a minus 8a. Now let us open the square bracket. 5a minus, there is minus sign outside, so sign of inside terms will change. Plus 12a plus 12a square plus 5a cube plus 11a minus 8a. Now let us simplify. Bring the like terms together. 5a cube plus 12a² + 5a + 11a - 8a. So this will give us 5a³ + 12a² - 16 will give us +8a. This will be our final answer. This was a very good question. Now after question number 11, let us move to the next question. The next question that we will take is question number 16. Question number 16. Question is 2a - (4b) - (4a) here it is curly bracket 4a - 3b - 2a + 2b. This 2a + 2b has bar. This is the question. So we follow the same order. First we insert the bar bracket, then small bracket, then curly bracket, and then square bracket. Okay. So first let us solve the bar bracket. Property of bar bracket is that the sign of the middle inside the bar bracket changes. Okay. So this will be 2a - 4b - 4a - 3b. Now your sign will change. It will become 2a - 2b. Now you can remove the bar bracket. It is solved. After bar bracket, we will solve the small bracket. 2a - 4b - 4a. Now small bracket we have to solve. So we'll take the like terms together. 3b - 2b will give us b. b - 2a. Now we can remove the small bracket, and since there is minus sign outside the small bracket, sign of inside term will change. Okay, so it will become 2a - 4b - 4a. Remove the small, open the small bracket, -b + 2a. Now small bracket will be removed. Now we will solve the curly bracket. So it will become 2a - 4b - 4a - b, 4a + 2a, 6a - b. So inside curly bracket, 6a - b. Now we shall remove the curly bracket. This will give us 2a - 4b - 6a + b. Sign of inside terms will change. Curly bracket has been removed. So this will become 2a - 4b + b, 5b - 6a. Now we can remove the square bracket also. So it will become 2a - 5b + 6a. 2a + 6a will give you 8a. 8a - 5b will be the final answer. Okay, this is also a very good question. Okay, after this question, we will take the last question, question number 17. You must be very, very careful while copying down the question from your book. Okay? You should not copy the wrong question from the book. So, do make sure to check the question once you have written in your copy. So, now question number 17. 5x - (4y) again minus curly bracket 7x, then small bracket 3z - 2y + 4z minus 3 square bracket x plus 3y minus 2z. Now all the brackets will be closed. Okay. Now let us solve it. 5x minus square bracket 4y minus curly bracket 7x minus, you can open this small bracket here, it will give us minus 3z plus 2y, sign terms will change, plus 4z. Now let us multiply minus 3 inside, so it will give us minus 3x minus 9y plus 6z. We'll remove the small bracket. Okay, now we will solve the curly bracket. So this will give us 5x minus 4y minus, let us solve the curly bracket, bring the line terms together, 7x minus 3x 4x, so 4x 2y minus 9y minus 7y minus 3z plus 4z plus z plus z plus 6z. So it will give us 7z. Okay. Yes. So now let us open the curly bracket. 5x minus 4y, sign of inside terms will change, minus 4x plus 7y minus 7z. We can remove the curly bracket now. Now let us open the square bracket. 5x minus 4y plus 7y will give us 11y minus 4x minus 7z. Now let us open the square bracket. 5x minus 11y plus 4x plus 7z. Okay, this will give us 5x plus 4x will give us 9x minus 11y plus 7z. So this will be our final answer. Okay, so this concludes exercise 8D. And remaining questions I would suggest you all to practice by yourselves. Okay, this is a very good easy chapter and very scoring chapter. So practice it nicely. Okay. Till then, take care. Thank you so much, Amitri.